has to be hit in the center because physics, if you hit at the top, the sound and the vibration is gonna change. It's gonna change the sound. But if you hit it dead center, it's actually a drier sound because obviously the sound waves are going all in equal direction, and so it's a lot louder than hitting it at the top. When you're a percussionist, you don't just play. You have to know how to make, build, repair, kind of like an engineer.
The larger it is, the larger the modes of vibration of the drum and the lower the frequencies are, which transmits very easily over long distances, which is probably why it's effective at sports arenas and things like that.
We double rimmed it and we cranked the lugs down and we cranked it and it got tight and then you hit it and it went boom.
Boom of the drum a good couple, five, six blocks away. We can really hear it. This drum was commissioned way back when in 1921. The drum travels with the All-American Marching Band to every one of their performances. For me personally, I like driving. I like the intensity of it. You are in control of the drum. You are in charge of all its spins, its maneuvers, every trick we do. You can see the two people in the back using all their strength to throw it down. The two people in the front, you know, they're holding the bar in control so the drum doesn't roll backwards. And everyone was working to one big, crisp, clean movement to get that trick executed. And that trick looked beautiful. It's rare that we get such like great footage of us like that we can break down and see, that looks cool, that looks really cool.
If you watch the confetti near the center of the drum, you see the surface of the confetti drop down. This wave of downward propagates out to the edge of the drum, strikes the edge of the drum, and comes back. And when it comes back, it's going up. And you see the ping pong balls are flying up there, but most of the confetti is sitting down by the surface of the drum. And that has to do with how objects, different types of objects, travel through fluids, so travel through the air. This is a very efficient shape for passing through the air. Now, on the other hand, a single piece of confetti has very little mass, right? It doesn't weigh much at all. And it has a lot of surface area. The confetti moves, you know, maybe a couple of inches. And then it starts falling downwards. So that is exactly what you see going on in this video. If this was in a vacuum, if we didn't have any air, ping pong balls and the confetti would fly off of there and they'd all go the same height. It's a really great mechanical engineering problem because it involves so many aspects of mechanical engineering. The surface of the drum is solid mechanics. Balls and confetti being thrown upwards is statics or dynamics. And what happens as they fly through the air is fluid mechanics.
And having something this big, you could actually see the reaction of a drum head. That's classic. Any drummer would love to see that.
I love telling people about the drum, about like how it's unique, it's one of a kind. There's not another like it in the world.
Being ambassadors for the university is one of the best things you could give back. It's nice to be able to go out there and say, you know, we represent the university and we do the best we can with class, with style, and with lots of knowledge to give to everybody else in the world.